Dude, get your cursor off the screen. Hey, everybody, it's the Poltergeist 5000 back with Sorry there wasn't an episode yesterday. I really didn't feel like recording. That's all there is to it. I didn't feel like recording. That's the end of the story. How many coins do I have? 16! That's like... What did I spend all my money on? Okay, well, before we start with Chapter 3, I want to go to the post office to read some post office... What are they called? Letters. It's like, what the hell? Okay. You seem to have some mail. Do I have new mail? No! I don't have new mail at all. Dude, pinky toe, thank you. Sheesh. Colorado's wife. I think I already read that one. Bombette. Dry Railroad. We read this after Chapter 1. Here you go. Dear Miss Bombette, we write this letter as a humble request to you, the most worthy and explosive of all bomb-oms. Got that right. It's still a long time off, but later this year we will be staging an opening event for a new dry railroad route. We feel the event would be a gala bash if we could enlist your bomb-bursting help. Crowds love fireworks. Anyway, we'll get in touch with you after your adventure ends to confirm the dates. Sincerely, Dry Railroad Transportation Department. Well, that's a little... I mean, like, opportunity, great. And Godspeed to you, Bombette, if you decide to go through with that in all your future endeavors, but it's kind of sad that, like, she's the only person who doesn't get a letter that's actually personal. I guess Colorado's wife isn't particularly personal, but then again, I forget what was in the letter. What do I have in my... Where am I going? I'm being stupid. That should be fine. I'm not gonna need... Wait, hang on. Why am I dead? Let's go sleep at the toad house. Why am I dead? Are you telling me I didn't sleep in the toad house? Sleep in the toad house? After that last episode? Anyway. I mean, I guess, yes, sleep in the toad house, but it would sound more natural to say sleep at the toad house. You know, sleeping in the toad house implies that there's no business there. It's just a building. It's just a place that you can go into that has, like, that has no other qualifications other than being a place. That's what it implies when you say, I slept in the hotel. You know, it's like, you wouldn't say, oh, last night I slept in a hotel. You would say I slept at a hotel, because it's an establishment. Well, anyway, I guess we'll switch in. I'll keep Bombette out for now. Let's head through here and head off to chapter... Oh, not yet. Hang on. Not yet. Okay. Ooh, it's spooky. Whoa, that's scary. Hello.
Pardon me, sir. Would you happen to be Mario? How do you do, sir? My master wishes to see you. If you would, please call on us at the mansion on the far side of River Forest. My master would also like me to add that she has in her possession important news regarding the star spirits. Please make haste. We shall await your arrival with a warm welcome.
All right, two-thirds face.
And if you don't come, we'll get you! Boo!
Jeez. Sorry. Okay. Excuse me. Well, here we go.
After 3, the invincible.
Holy cow, look at that background. Do I even put a background in this part? I mean, look how dark that is. Forever Forest Toast. I'm looking at Forever Forest. And more importantly, welcome to Chapter 3, one of my favorite chapters in the game. Actually, don't go there. So the trick to this place is that it's a big old maze, but you can recognize where you need to go because there'll be something weird about the path you need to take. But check the whole area first. Oops, that was dumb. Ow. Man, the sound it makes when Mario steps on something sharp in this game, it's like... In the sequel, it sounds like he steps on a spike, but in this game, it sounds like he stepped on like a little thumbtack on the ground, and it's like, yeah, nasty. That's nasty, man. Bonk. These guys would be no problem. I think these guys might actually just have 4 health, in which case that would have been a big waste there, but I need to switch in Goombario to tattle them. They're also kind of tricky to guard against, because they have a delay on their attack. Anyway. This is a piranha plant. Piranha plants pop out of the ground and unexpected moments will be on your guard. 5. Well, they do have 5 attack. They do have 5 health. Well, there you go. Their sharp jaws point upward, so you'll get bitten if you try to jump on him. And I'm gonna jump on him. There's that smug smile. It makes me hopping mad. Well, there ain't much else you could do when you were mad other than hop. You don't have any arms, so... You could writhe. You could shake and shimmy in anger. But I think hopping is the most natural thing that a Goomba could do in response to being mad. Anyway. So that's where we came in. This is the one where we came in. No, it's not. There was a sign where we came in. Yeah, here's where we came in. Getting lost already, and I haven't even left the first room yet. Jidleaf, man. What do you have to say about the locale, Goombario? This forest is really dark and spooky. People say that if you don't choose exactly the right paths, you'll get totally lost. I can believe it. This looks like the type of place where you get lost and then monsters come out of the grass and... Hey, did you notice that grass over there rustling? That's where I saw it move! Oh, man. Oh, hello. It's a bush.
What do you think you're doing?
Whoa.
This is Forever Forest. The path ahead of here is extremely dangerous. Didn't you know that? You'd better go back.
Bitch?
Okay, so that's your story. You're invited to Boo's mansion. You may pass, then. Listen carefully. If you want to get through this forest, you all have to pay really close attention to your surroundings. If you choose the wrong paths, you'll end up back in the forest edge before you know it. The areas around the correct paths will always look slightly different from the others. Watch carefully for clues. For example, in this area, take a good look at the inner trees as you walk around. In one of them, you'll spot strange glowing eyes. The exit near that tree is the path you want to take. These clues will be different in other parts of the forest. Watch the inner forest very, very carefully as you go. Into the unknown depths below.
Okay. Now there's a problem to this, though. There's an issue here. And the issue is that there are secrets in this forest that require you to go off the beaten path. And I'm not 100% sure where those secrets are. How much HP do these guys? This is a forest fuzzy. Forest fuzzies are always green. Six? Jeez, man, you're crazy. The fiends! Yeah, they're fiendish fiends. Oh yeah, if I do this, then I can... Well, I would've been able to... No, I wouldn't have. Because Goombario didn't attack this turn. This is the only way to kill them on this. Nice. Yeah. Bonk! Give me your key! This is the key to the box, man! And now he's dead. Or just knocked out. I don't know. He might be dead. But anyway, now we have both these guys. Tattle, I can switch in a party member who has a little more, bang for her buck. I'm talking about Bombette. Actually, I think Cooper might be a good person to have here. Okay, well there's the dog. Dog. Well, actually, this isn't very good at all. Man, Goombario is still the best person to fight these fuzzies with, because he's the only person who can do four damage in one turn. I can guard three of these guys in a row, it's no problem. You know what I keep realizing? I'm gonna have to have probably gonna be at least one part of this LP where I have two FAQ episodes in a row, and like that's not the end of the world, I know. It's basically a made up fake problem, but ow, okay. But Lord knows I'd like to keep it concise between chapters so we can get to the good stuff. But there's a dojo in Toad Town that I haven't even looked at yet, and like I've already passed the point where I'm now, like, way overpowered for the first fight they have there. So I really don't want to wait too long to do that. You see, here's the man. But let me hear. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to pull up a map. Because I know that there are secrets in this area. Forever Forest map. I know it's not in the spirit of things, but I'll still point out the clues you have to take to actually get through here. Really simple map here. Okay, anyway. Start. That's where the... Okay, so yeah, we're good. So have come through here. Dude, open BizHawk back up, you dumbass. Jeez. Okay. Now, in this area, if we go this way, we see one of these paths into the center, and this is what you're going to have to look for, is these paths in the center. What's your name? This is Oakley. He lives in Forever Forest. He guards the entrance to Forever Forest to prevent wanderers from getting lost. He helps any townsfolk who get lost inside that beard. For some reason, I feel like yanking it. Well, why'd you gotta be an asshole? Okay.
Listen carefully. If you want to get through this forest, you have to pick all the right paths.
Ooh, crack. Oh, mush, my back. Okay. Yeah, there are actually only two spots in this whole place. So there they have these really plump lips, which makes me uncomfortable, but hey. That's our signposting for the next secret path. So this one, is this the one where you see, like, the face in the tree? Not the eyes in the tree, but the face in the tree. Oh, hold on. Don't forget to pick this up. It's a flower, I think. Yes. Where am I?
Hey! Hello there! I'm a bumble from the land called Flower Field! It's a flower seed! Should I give it to you, or shouldn't I? Well, I suppose I'll give it to you. Here you go.
Okay. Okay, weirdo.
I might place a curse on you.
what a creepy bubble. Jeez. Now if we go one more. Yeah, here it is. Ah, the scary face in the tree! It's very frightening. Dude, go. Okay. Now. Here, there's a fork in the path. I'm not sure what the clue is gonna be here, but... Okay, don't get into a fight with that guy. But over here, the mushrooms light up. I don't know if they do that. Do they not do that in the other places? Okay, they light up in sequence. The other areas, they don't light up in sequence. But there, they stay lit for a lot longer, which means that this is also a path. There are two paths here. What the hell? Bees? A bee?! Yeah, I'm just gonna ignore you as best I can. In here, there's an HP plus badge! An HP plus dead plus dead. Let me go, I don't wanna fight you. And thankfully, the beehive is there to signpost our way back. And now we just gotta do a 180 degree turn to get back to where the mushrooms lit up in canon. What the fuck is the word I'm looking for there? Not canon. By that canon. I'm not talking right or something. Okay, anyway. Yeah, I got an idea. Here. Let's use Dizzy Shell. Holy cow, that action command is harder than I remember it being. Okay, but now those enemies are all dizzy for three turns, which is nice, obviously. Man, three damage? Yikes. That action command was a lot harder to pull off than I remember.
It's honestly not as good as I remember.
Stupid. Okay. Good guard. Nice on! I gotta find an opportunity to use a nutty cake in here somewhere, because I want to... Well, I guess I don't really need it yet.
But the thing is, we're coming up on a part in the game where we're gonna get a lot of items all at once.
Oh, you aren't coming after me? Okay, well, that's nice. I will use...
I will leave!
I'll just eat a lemon. I know, that's a waste, but hey, I got a blue pipe that goes right to... There's a recipe you can make later that uses a lemon that I would rather not, so I would rather not waste a lemon healing 1 HP and 2 FP, but... Especially when it only gives me one coin, but... I'm torn between wanting to... I'm torn between wanting to get coins, or wanting to empty my inventory for an area upcoming where we're going to be able to get a lot of items, from what I recall. Although there is also a store there, so we could put them away. Man, those yellow teeth are so gross. In the sequel, piranha plants are actually an enemy you don't encounter unless you go to the very end of, like, a... unless you go to, like, near the very end of a bonus dungeon. Which is really weird, but yeah, like... you don't encounter normal piranha plants anywhere in the main story, so they make them these super powerful enemies in the late... in like, the post-game that have 15 HP and 9 attack power. Like, it's ridiculous. I love wearing all these who cares badges. Just these badges that nobody ever uses because, like, who cares? It's just fun. Like, Zap-Tap is a really powerful badge. Zap-Tap is, like, one of the game breakers of the game. To a lesser degree, well, it's a game breaker, but it doesn't stop you from taking... Okay, well, it's a game breaker. But the point is, I'm not going... I like to equip a whole lot of random crap instead. Just because it's more interesting. It's like this one time I did a run of Paper Mario of the sequel. I did a run of the sequel to this game. Where I only equipped badges. Or every single time I found a badge that allowed me to do a special move like these, I had to equip it, and I couldn't take that badge off. So I had like 20 BP's worth, and I wasn't allowed to use any badges that outright raised my stats either. So like by the middle of the game, I had like all these crazy moves I could use in battle that all consumed FP, but I had like these like smaller buffs too, like keeping me in the game, and it was like literally the most fun I've ever had playing Paper Mario 2. Boom, bitch! 6 damage! 6 damage! I love you! Okay. Whee! Bonk. Man, that sound they make is so gross. What sound do they make in the sequel? They make like a grinding, so it's like, but like a sucking version, like, or something like that. It's like, the sound they make in the sequel is less of a kissy noise and more of like a, like, that's the only way I can think to describe it. It's like a grinding sound, but like, what? It's not really a, it still sounds like sucking. It just sounds like sucking through really pursed lips. Insert innuendo here. Yeah, okay. Insert innuendo. That's not how that works. I want to just fucking blow these suckers away. Just get out of my way, man. So I'm using refresh because it'll replenish a little bit of FP. Enough that I can use power bomb and just blow these guys into Wednesday, which is tomorrow. Get the fuck out of here. Anyway. Oh, I think I actually need to check them in this area. Okay, they all fall off. You guys also fall off. Why is it doing that there? Because you fall off. Excuse me. We're almost out of this place, I think. If we go this way, holy crap, that guy was like a hidden, that guy was fucking Solid Snake behind that tree. I didn't see him at all. That was crazy. Oh my gosh. No. There's too many of them. Taking a drink of my peppermint tea in the background. Peppermint tea with honey, it's for my throat. Yeah. because I woke up at like, by the time I actually got out of bed today, it was 10:30, and I was like, what? How is that even possible, man? I'll tell you how it's possible, because I slept in like a dumbass. But anyway, there's one last area here with a secret behind it. Now just remember. Whoa. Okay. It's the area where you grew some flowers. Hopefully they'll still be there. And here we can get an FP Plus badge. An FP Plus, dead plus. And just follow the spiders. Doo doo doo. Wah, wah, beep. Bee, boom, bada, doo, doo, doo. And now let's go. We're out. This is the end. Right at the 20-minute mark, too. Whoa, it's a scary mansion. Ah, it doesn't look so scary. I love the music in this area. Oh, finally. I couldn't stand being in that spooky forest another minute. Mario, I'm positive that's the mansion the creepy old ghost was telling us about. Yeah, showing off. What's over here? What's this? A vault shroom? That's weird. What a weird thing to find. I didn't make any hot shrooms while I was in town. That was dumb. In fact, I have very few. I have the fried egg and a super mushroom. That's it. Whoa. Holy shit, it's a ghost. And the music restarted.
Welcome, sirs and madams. I'm pleased you made it through Forever Forest. Was this my voice? I don't remember. My master awaits you in the room highest up in this lovely mansion.
Yeah, we saw it. We saw the mansion.
Please go to the third floor. There you will hear all the news of the star spirits. I'll see you there.
Are you gonna scare us? You're not gonna scare us?
Okay.
Because I've been burned before. Anyway, I think this bush right here gives you a strange leaf. A very rare leaf restores 5 FP. That's cool. And, there's a blue pipe spot here, so apparently we're going to get a fast travel point here. But for now, it's time to end the episode. And next time on Paper Mario, ladies and gentlemen, we will stretch! That's happening right now, not next episode. Next episode, we will go into Boo's Mansion. So bye.